down and get to be a part of this whole great discussion that we are having today to recreate and co-create a new destiny for India. And technology is now becoming and emerging as one of the biggest enablers to help us do it, can do magic in it. And we are hearing from everybody in what way different pieces of those technology advantages can be mainstreamed and get those benefits out of it. Just a couple of thoughts that I thought that I'll share with all of you today. We are a part of the IT world. All of you, for many years, have been doing, selling, servicing, integrating, or even marketing, or different parts of the value chain in this IT world. Some of you have been in this, and some of you that I have been meeting for a long, long time are in this industry for almost 2 decades. And when I think of IT world, and I can see it going through almost different eras. I remember the first era of IT world where all of you and many of you would have actually begun your business with, or during that time, was the IT era when computerization began to happen. We used to call it computerization. That was a simple IT world. It wasn't as complex as it is today, but it was purely automating, making the work simple, enhancing productivity. The whole emphasis was enhancing productivity, and that was the value creation of that time. 20 years later, the IT world changed, and it became basically changed because of internet era. So the internet era, and married with the information technology, and it began to create an industry called ITES. And a great amount of enabled services made India as a big outsourcing center. And I think that was a big turning point in this industry, and that was a great value creation. And gentlemen, 10, 15 years later, another development occurred. And that brought us into the third era of the information technology. And that was when connectivity became ubiquitous. Everywhere, every point, almost as much as you want. And now, you just heard him say, megabytes are passing. We're talking about gigabytes, terabytes. So even the quantum of data transfer can be enormous because of that connectivity. And that became a time when the telecom or the communication industry married this industry. And that created what we have begun to call it as smart connected world. So we are today in that era. It is a smart and connected world. The devices that we carry and the devices that we see in offices are all interconnected. And they are smart. And they have just about everything from hardware to software to data storage to sensors, and huge amount of analytics that comes out of it help us just about everywhere. It is going to create an enormous change in the world, and particularly in India, as we begin to adopt and begin to kind of learn to live in this world. But three important things are coming as big opportunities. So how does it matter to us as a part of this so-called third era of information technology evolution? The opportunities that it creates are of three kinds, broadly. One thing, and that's an implication for all of us here, one big thing is the apps. And I think we are at the cusp of huge number and variety and innovation that is going to happen in India in apps. And we will, in the next decade or so, see huge number and amount of different kinds of apps that will change the complexion of India. At the rural, languages, any applications, particularly government service deliveries through apps, will become as one of the most critical part of a value creation. Many of you will in some way be associated with selling it, maintaining it, offering cloud services in those apps, etc., etc. The second big thing where I see this creating a big impact, particularly in the B2B world, is this advent of business services. When devices being connected, and also because of this internet, there is so many of work that you can do remotely. And therefore, the business services will become or will make organizations a lot more efficient and a lot more competitive. And that's the area in which we see a lot of opportunities coming your way. As you're integrating, it's no more just a hardware and software integration, but the kind of services. It will redefine the way your businesses have been conducted so far and the value that the business has been creating so far. A new kind of value creation can happen, which can redefine your business completely. Something which you have not even entered into is going to become as a big opportunity. Take, for instance, digitization. India is still one of very big analog country. A lot of information still exists in paper. And therefore, when digitization begins to happen, and in many places digitization is happening in bytes and bytes of that data becoming mainstream, and then the access becoming easy, we will find a big change, a revolutionary change in the way people are accessing information. So that's a great opportunity, particularly in the area of digitization. And the third and the last thing, where this is going to create this kind of a smart and connected world, is going to create a big impact, is in the area of the social networking. The impact that the neutral voices can create is enormous. And that's the reason why, whether it is government or whether it is private companies or whether it is marketing area, social networking or social marketing is going to completely change the way we influence people. How do we use technology to influence people and not the words and not just the communication? It is through this technology that we will be able to therefore create a huge amount of marketing impact. It is therefore a different world, ladies and gentlemen, that we are going to live in. And not only will this world make our own life very much interesting and enjoyable and exciting, the way we use our devices, but most importantly, as business people, we will begin to see a lot more newer ways of value creation. So all the best to you to be a part of this world before we enter into the fourth era of information technology. So this is the only area in which there are rapid changes that are happening, something that we can't even dream of, and something which is very difficult to even anticipate. So enjoy your evening.